Hello students, welcome to biology lecture. So today we are going to discuss about the respiration process in cockroach. How this process going on in cockroach? Okay. Yes. Last video we have talked about the respiratory system in cockroach. So this respiration process, consists of two steps. In case of cockroach, respiration process consists of two steps. First is inhalation or inspiration. And the second process is known as expiration. Okay? So, first of all, in the expiration process or inspiration process, it is controlled by a type of muscles which are called turbosternal muscles. So they play an important role in the respiration process. So what is turbosternal muscle? As the name indicates, turbosternal muscle is present on the turgeon region and sternal means present on the sternal region. Suppose this is the cockroach and this part is known as turgeon, this part is known as sternum. So turgeon and sternum contain a special kind of muscles. These are known as turbosternal muscles, which play a very important role in the respiration process. So in the respiration process, first expiration, that is an active process. That is called active process. Okay? And inspiration process is a passive process. In the expiration process, why it is active process? Because here the muscle is going to contract. So there is contraction of turbosternal muscles. As they contract, then the volume of their body is going to decrease and the pressure is going to increase. So as a result, volume decreases and pressure increases. What is the meaning of this? That means as the pressure increases or volume decreases, then the air which is present inside the body of cockroach, that air comes out. It means that air rushes out because the gas or air comes from high pressure to low pressure. So this one is the expiration process. Okay. In contrast of expiration, inspiration is the passive process. Okay. Here there is a relaxation of muscles. So when there is a relaxation of muscles, which kind of muscles? They are turbosternal muscles. Okay, so they go in relaxed situation. As a result, what happened? Here the volume decreases in case of expiration. So here the volume is going to increase. And pressure is going to decrease inside the body. Okay. Pressure decreases inside the body. As a result, the air moves from outside to inside. Outside, that means high pressure, to inside, that is low pressure. Okay? So air moves from outside to inside, and here air rushes out. So this process is the inspiration and expiration. But in the cockroach, when the cockroach is moving, then these processes play a very important role. But when the cockroach is at rest, then what happens in the body of cockroach? What happens in the body of cockroach? So I'm doing this. After that, I will tell you. Okay. So when the cockroach, so first of all, when the cockroach is at rest, then what happened to the cockroach? What happened to the body of cockroach? Then the tracheal fluid, okay, released from tracheal cell, released from tracheal cell. Okay, when it is released from the tracheal cell, it gets diffused or filled up to the spiracles, which are the small openings through which air gets entered. So when the fluid is filled up to the spiracles, then air which comes out, it comes in contact with, okay, it comes in contact with what? Fluid, that is tracheal fluid, and this fluid carries the air. This tracheal fluid carries the air and reaches to the body cells. Okay, so here these are the spiracles. This spiracle have a sac-like structure opening that is known as atrium. Here this is trachea, and this trachea is divided into small branches. These are known as tracheoles. So here the tracheal cell is present. This is the tracheal cell which surrounds the tracheoles. So this one is the spiracle. This one is the atrium. Okay, this one is the trachea having a spiral kidneys, as I told you in the previous video. And these are the tracheoles. These are called tracheoles. Okay, and this one is the nucleus of tracheal cell. So when the cockroach is at rest, then the fluid secreted from the tracheal cell, and this fluid reaches up to the spiracle. Okay, so when the air comes from the outside, then this air comes in contact with the fluid, and after that, this air comes in contact with the fluid and it diffused, or because it reaches to the body cells. Okay, as the cockroach starts moving, then this fluid which is released from the tracheal cell, it comes back. Okay, so then when the cockroach is moving, then the fluid goes back. And air passes directly to the body cells. Okay? So this is all about the respiration process in cockroach. I hope this is clear to all of you. Thank you.